part of our economy. These were people whose support and encouragement I wanted.
Tonight, MPs dined early on the terrace of the House to help the farmers' cause, eating steak tartare, raw meat, to show that British beef still goes down a treat.
OK, kids, what do you want?
Hamburger and chips, please.
Cheeseburger and chips.
Cheeseburger and chips.
Hamburger and chips.
Beef was a multi-billion pound industry that had grown in the 1980s as demand skyrocketed.
I'm just going to have a word about bolognese sauce, and this is made with finely minced beef. It's got to be really thick to really coat the spaghetti.
Food manufacturers were developing new techniques to cash in on the meat craze.
When you kill an animal, you take bits of meat off, they're separated into the prime bits and the less prime bits. At the end, you're just left with brains and spinal cords and the central nervous system, basically. What the food industry realized in the 1980s was there was big profit to be made from this. If you sort of pressure cook it, you get a sludge of meat-like stuff called mechanically recovered meat that the regulators allowed to go in to meat products, meat pies, sausages, without being declared.
The public weren't told about mechanically recovered meat, nor that it contained spinal cord, the most contagious part of a BSC-infected carcass. School children were particularly at risk because of radical changes the Conservatives had made to school dinners.
In 1980, Margaret Thatcher's government passed the Education Act, which both privatised school meals and removed the need for school meals to have any nutritional value. The Education Act 1944 stipulated that school meals should provide 50% of a child's nutrition. After the war, that had been watered down to being 33% of a child's nutrient intake needs, and the Education Act abolished it altogether. School children were getting an increased exposure to BSC because school meals became about feeding kids for as little cost as possible. The Thatcher government believed in that, said, let the market rip. Public policy has no place in this. Oh, wow, was that a mistake.
By 1990, a whole generation were unknowingly eating meat contaminated with BSE.
I look at every photograph of Claire at a birthday party, surrounded by a mound of sausage rolls and sausages on sticks. And you just think, is that the one? Was it then? You're supposed to keep your child safe. You think about, are they getting good nutrition? You know, are they eating enough? Are they eating too much? And yet, I gave her something, or allowed her to eat something, which killed her. And, yeah, I think about it all the time.
We just bought what we could afford. Just stuff that wasn't expensive, but you could make a lot of it, feed the kids and feed us. And you believe the government.
Of course you did.
They were the government, you trusted them, everyone trusted the government. You know, never thinking that this sort of thing would happen. You did trust them.
There are new claims that unacceptable risks are being taken in the BSE epidemic.
By the spring of 1990, a young microbiologist in York was beginning to question whether beef was completely safe.
Dr. Steve Dealer says the official view
that there's no risk to humans by eating red meat is not borne out by his research work.
In the early 90s, I decided to have a look at BSE. I found that this disease was not acting in the same way as scrapie. It was as if it was a new disease. There had been some experiments carried out, and what they found was that some animals couldn't be infected with scrapie, but could be infected with BSE.
The concentrated purified extracts of diseased animal brains are deadly. A single drop injected into a laboratory animal produces the disease.
That meant we couldn't be sure it wouldn't have the ability to transfer to humans. And so I decided to speak out.
Well, unfortunately, this is a fatal disease with no method of treatment, no method of adequate diagnosis, which is passed from one species to another. I don't really think, at the moment, that there is no risk from beef.
The government have told us that meat is safe.
We don't know how big the risk is. We know that we'll have eaten about 1.8 million infected cattle by the year 2001. We've eaten about 1.5 million already.
After I spoke out, I got moved from a research lab to places where I couldn't carry out further research. People in power would much rather do their best to help farmers.
Those who are scaremongering not only harm the agricultural industry, but they do great harm to individuals who get frightened. I don't like the anxiety makers. I think that's a dishonourable thing to do, to frighten people unnecessarily.
Britain's 7 million cat owners are being urged to keep calm after yesterday's news that a cat had been found to have a disease similar to mad cow disease.
In May 1990, BSE did something alarming.
The Bristol cat was a worry. Here was the BSE agent jumping species and causing disease in another animal species in a way that scrapie hadn't. If BSE could jump into cats, could it also jump into humans?
No cause for alarm at all. This is only one cat death out of 7 million cats in the UK, and there is no reason for cause for concern at all.
The Ministry of Agriculture said, don't worry about it, folks.
A spokesman for the British Veterinary Association said the cat wasn't mad, but tipsy.
But I do know that a lot of the scientists were very, very worried indeed.
The cat had had a post-mortem, and there were lesions in its brain, similar to the lesions that are found in the brain of cows that are diseased. Now then, here comes with the problem of the sciences. You don't normally have autopsies on cats. Science couldn't tell you whether this was unusual or not.
Today, the body of a third cat suspected of suffering from the disease was sent for tests at the Central Veterinary Laboratory at Weybridge in Surrey.
The Ministry of Agriculture is urging owners whose cats die with mysterious nervous symptoms to take them to one of 20 veterinary investigation centres around the country.
That year, 15 more cats died of feline BSE. And the disease jumped to 14 other species that had eaten infected meat.
By the early 90s, it was clear that this disease was jumping species quite easily. The idea that it was inconceivable that this disease would transmit to humans was not correct. Of course it was conceivable.
If cows get it from the sheep and cats get it from the cows, in that case, why can't humans get it?
The Ministry of Agriculture continued to defend British beef.
Agriculture Minister John Gummer, out and about today, not only bought a burger, but gave his daughter first bite.
I was horrified. We were heading for this precipice. Gummer was determined, along with the Ministry of Agriculture, to keep on saying there is no risk at all to the population until the first case appeared.